Oh Lord, you're holy.
Oh Lord, you're holy.
Holy.
Lord, you're holy.
Holy is your name.
Holy.
I'm not worthy,
no, I'm not worthy.
Oh, your matchless grace. You're worthy.
You are worthy of this
worthy.
Of all praise. My life, you are my everything.
And I need you.
Savior Jesus Christ. Father, once more again, we come with bowed heads and humble hearts. Thank you, Father, for allowing us to assemble here to study another portion of your word. We just pray, Father, that you would bless each and every one of us. Father, that we would come with open hearts and open minds, that we would be able to study the things, Father, that will be presented unto us. We just pray, Father, that you would bless us, protect us, and keep us safe. Now, Father, these blessings and prayer in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Hello, hello, and good evening, family and friends, saints of God, lovers of the truth. Welcome to Bible study. Now, family, we rise to give God glory, and we're still going to rise to give him praise, for our great God is, in fact, worthy to be praised. Come on and help me out. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. How blessed we are to enter into this sacred space for spiritual nourishment and encouragement for our souls. We pray that this message finds you and your family doing well at this time. We praise God because he brought us over last week's troubles. He brought us over last week's hurdles, and he'll bring us over this week's obstacles as well. Do I have a witness in here on today? How many can testify that God is a mighty good God? How many can testify that God is a waymaker? How many can testify that God will provide blessings that we don't even have room enough to receive them? God is a mighty good God. Listen, if you're visiting this channel, we're just excited and delighted to have you come our way. And if you'd be so kind, help us spread the gospel of Jesus Christ by sharing, by liking this video, and inviting your family and friends into this Bible study. Now, it's always good to see the superlative saints of the South Union Church of Christ online, real time. And you know, oh, how sweet it is to still be a child of the King. Now, without any further ado, if you have your Bible, if you would please open up your Bible, navigate over on your electronic devices, Meet Us or Beat Us, Genesis, the 26th chapter. Genesis chapter 26. Genesis chapter 26. And let's see if there is in fact a word from the Lord. When you have Genesis 26, take a moment, plug into the live chat. It's time for our spiritual blessing. Amen. It's time for our spiritual blessing. Genesis 26 verse 1, you should find these words. And there was a famine in the land, beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto Abimelech, king of the Philistines, near Gerar. And the Lord appeared unto him and said, Go not down into Egypt, dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. Six promises for God's people. Six promises for God's people. Family, we live in a world whereby men will make promises and then break them on the same day. How many people have been privy to promises and covenants? How many people have seen that man cannot always be trusted? Man cannot always be counted on? You know, Peter brought this up and he said, The Lord is not slack concerning his promises, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering toward usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. God is long-suffering. God is a God who can be trusted, and God does not, here it is, renege on his promises. Oh, I need somebody who's familiar with some cards. God will not renege on his promises. God will not issue a promise and then go back on it. God won't tell us one thing and then go around and do another. We can trust God. God will come through because God is God all by himself. Amen. Well, now in this particular text, we should be encouraged to see that the same God who was with Abraham is the same God who's with Isaac. I believe that there are some modern day promises even embedded within this text, because these principles sit on a fixed axis of eternity. This means that God is the same and he changes not. And if we are his people, his promises are just as good for us today as they were in times past. His promises are just as sure for us today as they were centuries ago. We can count on God. We can, here it is, rely on God. And we know that God is going to come through time and time and time again. Well, you've got your Bible. It's time to go to work. Look at Genesis 26. And the Lord appeared unto him. Appeared unto who? Appeared unto Isaac, and said, Go not down into Egypt, dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. Look at verse 3. Sojourn in this land, and I will be with thee, and will bless thee. For unto thee and unto thy seed I will give all these countries, and I will perform the oath which I swear unto Abraham thy father. Now for today's study, we would like to concentrate our learning in verse number 3. because there are three promises that the Lord issues Isaac that are based right here in this one verse. You have it right before you. The first promise is, I will be with you. Take a moment and plug that into the live chat. God tells Isaac, I will be with you. I will be with you. Now, whenever family, God gives a promise, he's giving a promise based on eternity. This is simply to say that God can back up what he says because he swears by his own witness. Now, what does it mean to swear by his own witness? It means that there's authority and there's sovereignty in the word of Almighty God, and there is no greater authority outside or above God. So when God gives a promise, he cannot swear on anything higher than himself. Why? Because he alone is the sovereign one. He promises unto Isaac, I will be with you. Now this is profound and very important because God is announcing his presence, that he will literally walk with Isaac. Now watch this. When God says he's going to be with Isaac, he includes his presence. And when you get God's presence, you also have God's power. When you have God's presence, you also have God's provision. So this is very important for Isaac because Isaac is following the promises of God based on what information God gave Abraham, Isaac's father. You remember that it was God who promised Abraham that I'm going to bless you, and from you all families of the earth will be blessed. I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to curse those that curse you. God says, I'm going to provide for you, Abraham. I'm going to, here it is, give you an heir to your inheritance. Now, of course, inasmuch as God promised this to Abraham, these same blessings transfer over to Isaac. And now God is reassuring Isaac that I'm going to be with you just like I was with your father. Oh, family, listen, if we ever needed the presence of God in our lives, we need God in our lives today. Can you encourage someone right now in the live chat? I need the Lord every day of every hour. I need the Lord in a midst of a sinning and cursed and perverse generation and society. I need the Lord to guide, watch it, to guide me, to guide my family, to guide my thoughts, to guide and direct my steps. I need the Lord's powerful protective hand to cover me, to keep me. I need God's grace. I need God's mercy. See, all of this is indicated by, here it is, the presence of Almighty God. When you have God's presence, you have what God provides because of who he is. So this means I have grace, I have mercy, I have love, I have forgiveness. Come on, someone. I have peace. Yeah, you've got it. I have the ability to pray. All of this because God is dwelling with us. And let me tell you, if we ever needed the access and avenue of prayer ever before, we need it like never before right now today. Just take a look around and see all of the things that are going on in this world. And it lets you know that prayer is absolutely in order. So God tells Isaac, I'm going to be with you. And just like God was with Isaac, someone needs to know even on tonight that God is with you. If you are his child, if you're walking with him, it may seem like your days are dark. It may seem like the day is long. It may seem like you're never going to make it out. But you need to be reassured, family, that God has not forgotten about you. God does not forsake his own. Here it is. David says, I've been young and am now old. But one thing I have not seen, never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. So David understood that God is going to be with his children, and God is going to provide for his children, even when his children are unable to provide for themselves. Hallelujah, somebody. But then look at verse number three, because verse number three is very powerful, and there are some other principles embedded in the text. Genesis 26 and 3, sojourn in the land, and I will be with you. That's the first promise. But watch the second. And will bless you. Do you see that in the text? And will bless you. Now, to be blessed of God indicates that God is able to bless you immaterially as well as with material blessings. So there are immaterial blessings as well as material blessings. Now, the immaterial blessings, some of which we have forementioned, and that is grace, that's mercy, that's peace, that's love. You can't put a price tag on that. I mean, who can put a price tag on love? Who can put a price tag on peace? Who can put a price tag on mercy or on grace? There is no price tag. There is no equivalent value to peace of mind. And when God is with us, he will bless us, not just with material blessings or tangible blessings, blessings that we can see, but even blessings that are beyond human comprehension. Are you with me on today? Yeah. Who in here can testify? Just take a moment and think about how you were in a situation that could have taken you out and really should have taken you out. But it was the peace of God that passed all, come on, I see you, all understanding. And this peace of God held you together when you felt like you were unraveling. You felt like you were coming apart. But the peace of God brought you through the death of your loved one. The peace of God brought you through the loss of your job. The peace of God brought you through that family crisis, that family ordeal that potentially none of your friends were aware of. That peace of God sustained you and helped you to hold things together. Perhaps you were a single parent, and when you look back at your life, and even right now, you're going through things. But God is still with you. God is sustaining you. There were some dark days when you were rearing your children and you didn't know where the money would come from. You didn't know where the help would be found. But God was there and he sustained your energy. He sustained your health. He sustained your job. He sustained, here it is, your sanity. Oh, talk back to me in here, family. God said that he was going to be with Isaac, but he was also going to bless Isaac. And I don't know who you are, where you are, but I know one thing. We all need God to be with us, and we all should want God to what? To bless us. Amen. It's nice to have material blessings. It's nice to have things that can help make life to be more comfortable. But even if we don't have these material blessings, we still have the immaterial blessings that far exceed anything that an eye can ever see. All right, let's look at our third and final principle and promise in the text. Right here in verse 3, sojourn in this land, and I will be with you. Verse 1, first promise. And will bless you, second promise, for unto thee and unto thy seed, underscore that, unto you and unto your seed, I will give all these countries. You see that? Unto you and unto your seed, I will give all these countries. Someone type into the live chat, generational blessing. Amen. Generational blessing. Now, when we highlight generational blessing. What are we digging for? What do we have? Well, what we have here is the situation where God blesses generations based on the faith of previous generations. Are you with me? So God blesses generations based on the faith of previous generations, generations gone by. How many of us know that we are, here it is, living on the prayers of those who've been called to the other side? Could it be, family, that God blesses us not necessarily because we deserved it, not necessarily because we are righteous enough, but do you think it could be plausible, that it's possible that God blesses us based on the faith of someone who's been called to the other side? Maybe it was a praying mother. Come on, talk back to me now. Come on, talk to me in the live chat. Maybe it was a praying mother. Maybe it was a praying sister, a praying aunt, a praying grandmother, a praying father, a praying grandfather, a praying uncle. Maybe God is blessing us. Come on now. Blessing us based on the faithfulness of somebody who served him while they were alive. Maybe God keeps us even when we don't have enough sense not to do this or not to do that or not to think this or not to get involved in that. Perhaps God keeps us. Perhaps God works it out for us based on generational blessing. Amen. Come on now, this is getting good. Go with me to 3 John. 3 John, the first chapter. I have New Testament scripture for you. 3 John, the first chapter. 3 John, chapter 1. Let's see what John has to say about this. Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. Someone say, God is interested in my well-being. God is interested in our well-being. It's right here in the text. That you may prosper, how? In health, even as your soul prospers. So this is the complete blessing of God on your life. God wishes that his people prosper, that is to do well, that is to flourish, that is that their talents are multiplied, that their blessings are enumerated. God is interested in you and in me. He wants us to be abundantly blessed. I've learned, family, that it's not good to limit God. Amen. God can far exceed my wildest imagination, my wildest dream, my wildest desire. God can far exceed what I ask of him because he is God. Amen. God doesn't need permission from my neighbor, from my friend, from my family to bless me. And God doesn't need permission from me or from anybody else, come on now, to bless you. You got it. God is good and God is God all by himself. All right, family. Six promises for God's people. You got it. Six promises for God's people. I pray that you've enjoyed this first half of this study, and come back with us on Wednesday night so that we can wrap it up in study number 2. Listen, if this study has been a blessing to you, just share the good news with somebody, bless their lives, and let them know that as long as they stay with God, God's going to work it out, no matter what it is. Thank you for tuning in on tonight. Listen, if you'd like to continue in further Bible study, or if you have a Bible question, the number is right there on the screen. Just give us a call and we'd love to hear from you. Now, as we sign off, looking forward to the next study, we pray that you have a peaceful, prosperous, and productive week. And remember that here at South Union, we love you, and there's not a thing that you can do about it. Be blessed in the Lord, and we'll see you real soon. Take care, and good night.
Oh yes, your word, your holy saint. Oh,
holy is your
name. Can we say that you are worthy of all the praise? Put a smile on my face. You're my everything. Oh, bowing down to spirit and truth. Oh, I kneel for your throne, oh Father. I worship you, Lord.